an earthquake, birds and snakes and airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. I have a hurricane, listen to yourself, churn world, serve its own needs, dummy, serve your own needs, feed it off an ox, speak, grunt, no strength, the ladder starts to clatter with fear, bite down, high choir and a fire, representing seven games in a government for hire and a combat site. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world.
Hello, tennis players. This is Steve Hess. I'm the league coordinator of Gladiator Tennis, and this is our third encounter with a real-life gladiator. Thanks to Lisa Jett for suggesting our coronavirus theme song, and she and her husband, Jim, are the real-life gladiators that I'm going to interview today. These guys make tennis happen wherever they go, and they have the distinction of being founding members of not one, but two of our leagues. In 2015, they were founding members of our St. Louis League, and just this last winter, they started the Delray Beach League. So here's Jim Schwartz and Lisa Jett. Hello, Lisa, Jim.
How are you, Steve?
Good, good. How are you doing?
We're doing all right.
I really specifically wanted to interview you, Lisa, because you started the Delray Beach League this winter. And Jim, I specifically wanted to interview you as well because you've been so core to everything in the men's side of the league in St. Louis. I think you played every single season that we've had.
I think that's right. I think I was in from day one. That's correct.
You finished as the number one 4.0 player, I believe, before the playoffs started.
I think that's correct. I think I had some carryover 3.5 points as well that helped my cause. But
okay. What's been your most memorable match?
So I call him my nemesis because I think Robbie Shackles has been in the Gladiator League since day one, as well as long as I have been. And I think he started out as a 3-0 and he's moved up with me. And every year we play, you know, two or three or four times a year. And I know I'm always in for a tough match. He and I have had some really grueling matches together. So whenever I tell Lisa that I'm playing my nemesis today, she knows that, oh, you're playing that Robbie Shackles guy. So I would say the matches between Robbie and I are most memorable.
And you also played some mixed doubles together in our league. We had our first mixed doubles season last year. How did you find out about Gladiator Tennis in the first place?
I found out first and from another USTA woman that I played with, Beth, who I think helped you get a lot of things up and going in St. Louis when you first started.
Beth Jameson.
Yeah, I immediately started playing with her. I played in the 3-0 league and immediately started playing and got Jim in, you know, interested in the men's league as well. And it's been a great experience, and it's been great to meet other people that we weren't always meeting in USTA or World Team. You know, yeah. And some of the same, of course, but sure. Many new people.
Yeah. So, yeah, you play a lot of other tennis as well. Like you mentioned, USTA, World Team Tennis. I mean, you play, I don't know how you fit all the tennis that you have in your life into it. I was looking at all the pictures that you sent me, and you're playing all over the country. You're watching tennis everywhere. You play together mixed doubles. You've made a lot of tennis friends. You're really at the center of a whole lot of tennis. How did you even start playing? How did you get so addicted to it?
Yeah, we always say we drank the tennis Kool-Aid for sure. We're on board with anything, watching, playing, anything. I started as a kid in middle school, and I played, you know, a little bit competitively there till about the age that I moved up to the women's league, and then it was just tough to join the 18-year-olds when you were a little younger. And I just kind of fell off and started playing recreationally, and then came back into it as my son got older and played in high school. I thought, why am I not playing again? I love this sport. So picked that back up there. And I'll let Jim tell his story on how he started with tennis.
Interesting story, Steve. I got to tell you. So I didn't play tennis until I met Lisa. And we met online on an online dating site, and there was a picture of her hitting a tennis ball, and I thought that looked interesting. So we went on our first date, and it went really well. And so we scheduled a second date, and our second date was actually taking in a little tennis. It was in December, so we played indoor, and she beat me pretty handily, I got to tell you, that first time out. It was a little humbling experience for sure. And ever since, I have been hooked on tennis. I can't get enough. I really enjoy it.
So your first date was on a tennis court. You had never played before, and Lisa was, at that point, you know, a veteran of tennis. So you're on her turf. I mean,
I was in over my head. I was in way over my head. I didn't know what I was getting into.
I could see he had the skills. He was an athlete. I'm like, okay, we can bring this one.
It was great. We've been playing ever since. And the doubles thing is something that we really enjoy. We were both more singles players when we met, and just over the course of time, you know, we both come to really enjoy playing doubles together. It's great fun. We travel. You know, we go on trips and we can play, you know, against other couples and friends. It's just a great way to socialize.
For sure.
Yeah. And it was no fun doubt. With the Gladiator Mixed Doubles League that you put together here. I think we've only had one season of that. That's all we played. I believe that was the first season. And we definitely met different people than we've met in the world team. And we've met people right here in our community, really close. And a lot of young people, but we're trying to keep up with them.
It's been kind of rough for a lot of us having to, you know, being told to stay at home or to socially distance. What have you guys been doing during this whole time?
Yeah, we have picked up the tennis racket. There's some courts open in the county of St. Louis still, and Jim and I have been able to go out and play. And we took the 100 Volley Challenge that Djokovic and I think
it was Federer
had going. And I think Andy Murray, but we were able to do that pretty quickly.
What are we up to?
16.
116. Woo, 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 woo.
And other than that, I'm also a personal trainer. And so poor Jim has had to deal with the brutal workouts every day, but it's been fun.
Oh, you made me do your workouts.
Oh, she's killing me.
Jim, you have a lot to credit Lisa for there. I mean, getting into tennis, and now she's making you work out. I mean, you'd probably be just a big blob otherwise, right?
Hey, Steve, that's one way to look at it. We'll leave it at that, okay? We'll give her full credit.
Okay. So it's really cool to see these pictures of you guys at Delray Beach. And this is just a wonderful surprise for me when you phoned me up last fall, Lisa, and said, hey, I spend my winters in Delray Beach, and I got a bunch of friends there, and I want to start a Gladiator Tennis League there. And then it happened. Can you talk about what made you even consider that idea?
Sure. I'll give Jim some credit, because Jim also said, well, you love the Gladiator. Why don't you think about the Gladiator down there? Honestly, he gets the credit for that one.
Thanks, Jim.
But
no problem.
But there was so much doubles down there. There's a lot of doubles. Even their what we play down there, divisional tennis, is all doubles. You don't have any singles courts. And I was really missing that down there and having to look for it and find it. And I knew there was a niche that I had some friends that played that said, I'd love to play on a regular basis and something that counts. And we had done a tennis ladder once. And so really, I just started talking to friends and they said, I'd like to do it. And we got a minimal amount, but enough to have it. And I think it will grow from there, because we talked to people about it. We had that little wonderful tournament at the end that you let us do, the round robin, and everybody had a lot of fun with that and invited a few extra people that weren't playing, and they were pretty interested in that. So that was great. So in the left in the back is Sophia. Sophia is, she's a resident in Delray all the time, and she played in the league with us. And right next to her in the light blue is Mary Luce. And she was somebody who was going to play and hurt her foot and had an injury, and came back towards the end and played this round robin with us. And she's ready to play the next time for sure. Standing up there in the middle, tall, with that you can see the thing around her neck, the vest, that's Shari. Shari's very competitive. very excited player. She's from Canada, but lives in Delray now, and tough player. She's a 4-0 player, probably playing with most of us 3-5s in this league, but we held our own. And yeah. Then in all black there is Marsha. Marsha is definitely she likes doubles. She's definitely a singles player. One of the first singles players I played a lot with when I came to Delray, and she lives in West Palm Beach. Right next to her in the white and the purple, that's my closest and first friend in Delray. Her name is Ruth Emile, and she lives in Canada and is only down there in the winter like I am. We play division tennis together and a lot of tennis. She's my normal doubles player, but I got her playing singles, and she rocked it, and she did great at it, and she enjoyed it. And then all the way to the far right there standing is Colleen. And Colleen is actually works in a tennis facility, a private club there in Delray. She's got all of her white clothes on. It's an all-inclusive kind of uppity place. She loves it. She's a great player. Then down there in the front, that is when we play the round robin. That is my my partner, Erica. Erica played in the whole year too. And she's good, tough, fierce competitor. Her and I took second place in the little round robin in the back there. And then there's me, obviously, in front with my little two up for second place.
Okay. Yeah, that's great. Was that at the Delray Beach Tennis Center, or was it?
Yeah.
It was. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. It looked like it. I got a chance to visit you and Ruth playing at the Delray Beach Tennis Center, and I just love Delray Beach. We went out to eat afterwards. They've got such a cool nightlife around there. The dream for me would be to actually have a national tournament at that stadium sometime down the road.
We love that idea. I actually told the girls, you said, hey, we could maybe get this really going and play some championship here. Oh, yeah. So they were all really excited about that. It's fun to do destination tennis. We've played in other leagues where as you win, you move on, and then the championship matches and things are in other cities, and we really enjoy doing that. We're always wanting to win to get to that location, and that's a great thing, I think, for Gladiator, too, to say, hey, keep going, and here's what's coming for the winners.
It'd be great. Yeah, they play a 250-level professional tournament there every year in February, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Mid-February.
Yeah.
Yep, you guys threw us to Delray first. Jim found the tournament on TV, and we were down there, and we got some tickets, and he said, let's go check this place out, and fell in love with that town, and stayed there and rented for one winter and said, we got to live here. This place is great.
Yeah. I had never heard of Delray Beach until I saw it on the Tennis Channel. And I Googled Delray Beach, and I'm like, wow, it's right down there by Fort Lauderdale. We need to check that out. The next February, Lisa and I were in South Florida sitting in on the Delray Beach Open, and it was a great experience. We've been back ever since, every year.
So tennis is what drew you to Delray Beach for your winters then?
Absolutely is. It was that ATP 250 Series tournament that we saw on the Tennis Channel.
Yeah.
That's how we found the city. Yeah.
Wow. Wow, you guys are tennis is really shaping your lives.
It is. In fact, we need a bigger house in Florida now because everybody wants to come down for that tournament. So it's going to shape our house a little more too. So,
who would you say is the greatest of all time?
I really love, and I'm a big fan, and I would say I'll put him right up there, Roger Federer. That's the way I go. And if you seen me with a hat on, it usually has an RF on the top. So
okay.
How about you, Jim?
Oh, me? Yeah, it's hard to top Roger, but I got to admit, Steve, I am more of a homer. I'm always rooting for the American, regardless of where they're ranked or who they're playing, how big the match is. I always tend to lean towards rooting for the American. And that's what's great about the Delray Beach Open is typically they draw a lot of the Americans that play there. So I get a chance to see those guys up close and personal, which is a lot of fun for me.
Yeah. Well, that was my next question. Because you go to this tournament, have you met any famous tennis professionals while you're there?
Oh yeah, we have. I've gotten my picture with a lot of them because I like to jump in and get my picture on things. Jack Sock was one that everybody will remember for sure. And the Bryan brothers, they do tournament little play there and stuff. So we've, definitely ran into them a few times there. Ryan Harrison. And then
Del Potro.
Yep.
Yeah. We've got a lot of signed tennis balls because you can get, you know, you're so close. It's such a small venue. You've got an opportunity to get up close and personal with these guys, and and they practice on the back courts, and you're literally, you know, a few feet away from them. It was funny. Funny story this past February. And I don't even remember who it was, but one of the guys was practicing on one of the side courts, and he asked his fellow competitor if he was available the next morning at 10 to practice. And he said that he wasn't sure that he would. And I offered my services to step in. And I said, I'd be more than happy to give you my number if you want to hit a few balls. And they both chuckled and they thought, okay, leave me alone, old man.
And I got one more humorous story from this year for Jim. Jim got Kyrgios' signature. So Kyrgios was there and he was hitting some balls and he got a signature. And the next day he was going to play a match. We show up for the match and they're like, Kyrgios is out. He has a wrist injury. So I said, it was from signing your ball. And Delray's finest. She's not in the tournament, but she was this year. You might have heard of her, Coco Gauff. Upcoming young female player. She is from Delray. Jim and I have played on the court right next to her a couple of times in the past years. And we looked over there and said, who's hitting those balls? And how does that sound like that? Because that's not what our ball sounds like. And we knew she was upcomer. You know, we knew she was going to be good. And here she is. And she actually filled that Delray Beach tennis stadium for the first time since they've opened. And she was just an exhibition match at the Delray tournament this year.
Yeah, she is a great player, and it looks like she's going to be a really nice role model for everybody as well. I mean, they have a good family behind her. So that's great that you were on the court next to her actually hitting. It's just amazing.
Yeah, 14 years old when we first saw her, and she was phenomenal. I'd like to thank you, you know, for building the league in St. Louis. It's a great opportunity for me, you know, to play a lot of tennis because I just like the flexibility that this league offers, and I enjoy the competition. And it's been a great experience really all around.
It was great to start this in Delray. It just was really fun. And this little COVID, you know, standby time has hurt that, but we're going to get back in there and we're going to build. I really believe you can build that area and that a lot of people will come and play because people were excited about it.
We're all hoping to get out in the courts in maybe a couple of weeks to at most a month. The Gladiator League starts June 4th. So,
awesome.
Yeah, I'm ready. And we're going to sign up for that mixed doubles. We're coming back out to get them. Yeah.
That's right.
We were one set away from winning that last year, Steve.
One set away from winning it. We're ready. We're like, we're coming back to you guys. We'll be back.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
Good seeing you. Take care.
Bye. Okay.